Hát, sziasztok mindenki! Lindie vagyok. Két éve magyarul tanultam, de már nem tanultam, és aztán megálltam. De most újra, nem újra, és most ismét magyarul tanulok. Nagyon boldog vagyok, szerintem a magyar nyelv nagyon szép, nagyon érdekes, és igen, ez a magyarul videóm. Két éve. Itt. Két hónapja magyarul tanulok. Én szeretek nyelveket tanulni, de a magyar nyelv nagyon nehéz. Szerintem a magyar nyelv nagyon-nagyon érdekes, és I don't know how to say this in Hungarian. I just felt like I really need to study it again and put my efforts in Hungarian again. Szóval ma akarok beszélni, hogyan tanulok magyarul. Mert csak nyelvet tanulni, nincs időm. Szóval hétfő és csütörtök a magyar nyelv napom van. Hétfő és csütörtök minden nap csak hallgattok magyarul, és csak próbál beszél magyarul. Ez nagyon nehéz! Egy héten 4 óra tanulok magyarul, de nem tudom, hány óra hallgatok podcastot, és appot használok, és zenét hallgatni. Minden nap akarok csinálni valamit magyarul. Például appot használok, hogy podcastot hallgatok, és tandem appot magyar barátommal, nem tudom, használok, és appot. És persze a magyar zenét playlist is van. Nagyon sok hallgattam ez a playlist, mert nagyon szeretek a magyar zenét. Például Well Hello, és New Level Empire, és nagyon teszik a New Level Empire. Van egy másik nyelvi apot, a címe Bluebird Languages, és minden reggel hallgatunk az Bluebird Languages podcastot az uhán alatt. És az app jó, de egy kicsit unalmas. Néha másik nyelvtanulás appot használok, mint a Duolingo és Mondly, és not really famous apps, de például, nem tudom, az a Do You Speak Hungarian appot is van. Sok appot van, igen. Most otthonról dolgozom, és amikor otthonról dolgozom, szeretek podcastot hallgatni, például product designról és tervezőről. Tudok koncentrálni, mert a munkám tervezés. Mivel tervező vagyok, tudok sok podcastot és zenét hallgatok minden nap, amikor dolgozom otthon. Igen. Szeretek hallgatni például Ide Hallgaszt és az Önálló Nyelvtanuló. Igen, és másik podcast a címe Product Design Stories. Nem tudom, de sok hallgatok, igen. Nem értek mindent, de néha hallgatom Hungarian Podcast, Hungarian Pod 101, és Hungarian with Cici. Nagyon szeretek Cici, a barátnőm. Cici a barátnőm. Why is Hungarian so difficult? Okay, rendben. Hétfő este van egy magyar óra a tanárommal. Nem sok, hanem 30 perc. Nem 30, 45 minutes? Nem tudom. I don't know the numbers in Hungarian. Nagyon jó, nagyon szeretek a magyar órám, és minden óram előtt szavakat írok, sok írok. Szerintem, amikor írni valamit, tudok jól tanulok. This is hard. Amikor magyar órám van, beszélünk sok mindenről, például a tervezés, Szingapúr, zenét, film. What is a movie? Filmet, igen. És sok mindenről, igen. És a hétvégén szerettek nézni magyar filmeket, például testről és némekről. Nagyon-nagyon jó volt. I cried. It's a great movie. Angol felirattal néztem, és a tanárom is tetszik a film, és a filmről beszélt. Az a magyar nyelvkönyvem, de nincs angolul. Ez kicsit nehéz, igen, nem kicsit, hanem sok nehéz, túl nehéz. Szóval néha használok az a könyvem. Igen. Szerintem ez egy nagyon jó könyv, de mert nincs angolul, ez kicsit nehéz. A hang a website-ban van. How should I say this? Hang van a website-on. Igen. Why is Hungarian so hard?
Please bear with me for the next part. I will be talking in English because it's a bit hard for me to explain how I learn Hungarian in Hungarian when I'm such a beginner. So the first thing I did, which I also mentioned in my video from 2 years ago, is to change my phone completely into Hungarian. Right now you'll actually see I'm listening to a Hungarian podcast about product design. And the rest of my phone's interface and all my folders is also in Hungarian. And it just reminds me to constantly see the language and helps me learn words like copy or paste, those kinds of words that I use every day on my phone as well. So 3 of my favorite podcasts that I listen to, the first one is called Product Design Stories. I actually just discovered it today. And because it's exactly relevant to my field of work, it's really interesting to listen to. So I think I remember words and sentences more when it's relevant to my interests. So because I'm a UI UX designer, listening to a podcast about that is very relevant. And of course, I don't understand everything, but it's still a lot of listening practice. Now, I'm not saying you can completely learn a language just by listening to it. You have to actively engage with it. So I try to look up words as well relevant to the field. So if I know I'm going to be listening to something about design, maybe I'll look up an article related to design. All I need to know is like the main keyword, which is tervezu or tervezish, which is design. And then I'll find some kind of article about it or some kind of blog post. And I'll just look up basic words there just so that I have a little like arsenal of vocabulary so that when I do listen to a podcast, I can be like, oh yeah, I remember that word. As I mentioned, I do love writing. One of my new Instagram posts actually yesterday, which you can look at, is titled, Why I Write So Much When... Oh, that's really dark. Why I Write So Much When Learning a Language. And I said I remember words better when I learn them in the context of a sentence that I'm likely to use in daily life. And studying words related to one topic is something that's been very helpful to me. So last lesson I had with my tutor on italki was we talked about a house or an apartment. It's good to talk about a single topic each time because I'll more likely remember the words that are grouped in that topic. Then I had a bunch of words like living room, carpet, mirror, kitchen, bathroom, those kinds of words. And then I tried to make sentences. So here's my little essay that I wrote afterwards, and then I got my tutor to correct it. So it's a very basic paragraph. I'll just read a few sentences about my house. So, egy szobában van a konyha, a nappali és a hálószoba. Mivel nagyon szeretem a növényeket, hát növényem van a lakásomban. Ezen a héten új szőnyéget vettem. I bought a new carpet. It's a very hard word to say. Rózsaszínű. This is the new carpet I bought. Terasz is van, szép a kilátás, és néha kint ülök, de meleg van, mert túl meleg van, amikor esik az eső, kint ülök. Stuff like that. So I just try and make any kind of sentence that pops in my head. Even if it's wrong, I will get corrections, and that is how I learn full sentences and just not single words. My notebook is basically notes that I take during my italki lesson. So it's really messy, and it's just some things that my tutor has said, some new words. I don't necessarily have a very structured format for my notebook, but something I do that is very helpful is before my lesson, I will write a few sentences that I want to talk about. So I know he will always ask me what I did on the weekend. So I'll write down, maybe I watched a movie, or I met my friends in a cafe, or I was studying this and this. And then I write those sentences and I say it to him, and then I get corrections as such. And then we kind of have like a topic to talk about each time. After the lesson, I will write down some of the sentences we went through, because he always types it on Skype for me while we're talking, which is very helpful because I like to see the word and hear it so that I can practice speaking it. And then I have a second Hungarian notebook, which is more of a neater review notebook. Some people ask me if I ever do go through my notes, and yes, I do, because Hungarian is very hard and I need to review it a lot so that I can remember it. So this is my messy notebook for italki notes specifically. This is the other notebook I have. They are both pink. I like to color coordinate. So I have a page specifically for phrases, which are full sentences that I learned in my lesson or something I picked up maybe while talking to a language partner. I don't actually use this notebook a lot. I like to finish up one notebook at a time. So this is my notebook that I use during our lessons. As you can see, my handwriting is just atrocious, but I just need to get the information down as quickly as I can while we're talking. For some reason, it helps me remember it more if I hear it, I say it, and I write it down. Ah, here we go. So for some reason, we always talk about my earrings, so I wanted to say, like, today I bought new earrings. They are purple and yellow. I don't like yellow, but I think these earrings are pretty. So I just write like a few sentences that's a starter to a conversation, and then we continue the conversation and I will take notes during when we talk. During when we talk. My English is so bad. Help. Yes. So I don't even care about having a tidy notebook. I just need to get everything down in one place. We talked about fruits as well.
Sajnálom mindenkit, a magyar nyelv még mindig kezdő, sem könnyű. Nem tudom jól beszélni, és remélem jobban beszélek. Köszönöm szépen mindenkit. Thanks for watching. Bye bye, sziasztok.